The shadow here. I'm just helping you guys out with a little bit of geometry today. Today we're going to talk about some of the different shapes that we know. And I know we spent some time in number corner doing this, but I wanted to review it really quickly before I give you guys your task on one note tomorrow. So I have here some vocabulary cards that we're going to do on this side of the screen. And then over here where my picture is, and there's that white box, I'll be using a little whiteboard app to be able to draw them as an example. So the first one we want to talk about is a polygon. And looking at these shapes over here, I want you to think about what do those shapes have in common? You might have noticed that they're all closed. That means that there's no open space. So if I look at what the definition of a polygon is it's a closed two-dimensional. That means it's flat with three or more sides. Now, if we think about a shape, if I have two sides, and I know I'm not a very good drawer, especially on the computer, if I have two sides, can I make it closed? Think about that one. Can you make a closed shape with two sides? Probably not, and that's why it's called a two-dimensional. That means that it's totally flat, and it has to have three or more sides. So with three sides, I could make this shape. Now think about, what shape is that? If you thought that was a triangle, you're right. So now let's look at the second card. It says two-dimensional, and I just gave you a little heads up. The two-dimensional means flat. So if I look at the answer for two-dimensional, what it means, the definition, it's a flat shape that has a length and a width, a shape that has area but no volume. I know we spent some time this year talking a little bit about length and width. If I review length and width, length means how long a shape is. So in this rectangle over here, if I label this side as 8 and this side as 4, I would say that it has a length of 8 and a width of 4. Okay, so length is how long, width is how wide. Remember, area means that I can make little square tiles. So that area of this, and I'm not going to do a very great job. I'm going to try my best, though. That's all I'm asking of you during this time. Remember, things may not on computers go exactly how we want them to, but as long as it's close, that's good. So I have 8 this way. And I have 4 this way. So that means my area, if I counted each one of those boxes, I would have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You keep counting. 9. If you came up with 32, you were correct. Or I can write this out as a multiplication of saying 4 times 8 equals 32. Perfect. So if we move on to our next vocabulary word, I'm going to go ahead and erase our whiteboard. So our next vocab word is the word angle. So angle, if we think about it, we talked about right angles, we talked about acute angles, and we talked about obtuse angles this year. So let's remind ourselves, angle is the shape formed by two rays or line segments that share an endpoint. Angles are measured in degrees. So remember, this one up here, we talked about that one. This one is a right angle. That means that it's the same as a piece of paper. Okay, so that's that 90 degree right angle. Now, if I switch gears and I talk about an acute angle, this one right here is an acute angle. That means it's smaller than 90. And my last one over here is an obtuse angle, and that means it's bigger than 90. So if I were to look at this triangle, I have two acute angles and then I have one obtuse angle. Now this rectangle, remember, quadrilateral, if I have four sides, I don't have to have all right angles. But if I'm a rectangle or a square, I have to have four right angles. That means that they have to be just like a piece of paper, okay? So these four, notice it makes little tiny squares, are all right angles. Let's move on to our next word. So our next one is side, and that goes right along with angle, because between those sides is where I have those angles. So this square, I have one, two, three, four sides. This trapezoid, or rhombus, we're gonna talk about that in just a minute, has four sides as well. This triangle has three. I want you to stop and think, how many sides does this star have, and what would you call this shape? How many sides does that actually have? If you came up with this star having 10 sides, you're right. Now this shape over here has six sides. Hold on to that. Let's see if we can figure that one out. A side is just a line segment with other line segments that form a flat two-dimensional shape. Our next word is a quadrilateral. Quadrilateral just means I have four sides, okay? So quad means four. Now within quadrilaterals, if I look at this shape, I have a rectangle, I have a kite, I have another funny shape, I don't know the name of that one. I have a rhombus, I have a square, I have a trapezoid. So a quadrilateral is just a shape with four sides. Parallelogram, on the other hand, is a two-dimensional flat shape with four sides, but, key word, both of them have to be parallel. Remember, parallel means that I'm on a train track. That means those two lines are never going to touch. So that would mean that the train can keep going. This is what parallel looks like, okay? Now, if I was working with something called perpendicular, these two lines would be perpendicular. And here's why. That train is gonna crash right here. We're gonna have a big problem there, okay? So parallelogram means that both sides are parallel. So if I looked over here at this shape, I have one, two. There's one set of parallel, because parallel means I have to have two sides that are parallel. One, two. I have two sets of parallel lines on this shape. One this direction, one that direction. That's what makes it a parallelogram. Notice though, a parallelogram doesn't have to have all right angles. I can be a trapezoid, or I can be a rhombus and still be a parallelogram. Let's move on to our next shape. Oops, wrong one. Uh-oh, there we go, rhombus. So a rhombus is a two-dimensional shape that has four congruent sides. Congruent means same, okay? So if I have a congruent side, that just means that they're the same. Now when I'm working with shapes and I'm talking about the same, we're talking about the same length. So a square would be congruent, a rectangle would not, because a rectangle sides have two long sides and two short sides, okay? That's what makes it a rectangle. A rhombus, though, has to have four equal sides. So we could have a square could be one, or I could have one that's smushed down to the side, like we've talked about before, where you push down when it slides. That's when I have those ones that have obtuse and acute angles. Our next word that I want to talk about is square. Remember, a square is a rhombus because I have four equal sides. But I also have to have four right angles. Remember, right angle means that it's that corner of a piece of paper. It's 90 degrees. So that's what makes a square a special rhombus. Trapezoids, on the other hand, means that they have four sides, but only one is parallel. So So if I were to look over here at this shape, and I'm going to try drawing it, and I'm really sorry, Machado's not an expert, but I'm going to be one if I keep practicing. So if I look at this one, I have parallel sides right here and right here. Those are my parallel. My perpendicular sides, though, is going to be this one and this one. Notice that they intersect. We have a little bit of an issue. They crash. So my train can only run one direction on a trapezoid. My next one is a triangle. A triangle just means that I have three sides. Most of us are pretty good with triangles. And my last one that I wanted to just let you guys know, a three-dimensional shape is similar to a two-dimensional shape. Two-dimensional, remember, is flat. Three-dimensional means that I have volume. Like, I could actually put something inside of it. So an actual box that I can put things inside of, or a cone I can put things inside of, or a soccer ball that's a sphere that I put air inside of.
Hello, third graders. We are going to look at a quick picture, and you're going to tell me which one doesn't belong. These pictures are taken from a website that is called Which One Doesn't Belong? And here's how this little math puzzle works. Each one of these shapes has a reason it doesn't belong with the others. So we started out with a fairly easy one, and I want you to look at it and see if you can figure out why each one doesn't belong with the other ones. I'm going to give you the first one. We'll do that one together, and then you can do some thinking. If we look at the diamond that is not colored in, that one doesn't belong because the other diamonds, the other shapes, are colored in. All right, let's see if you can find another one that doesn't belong with the others. Well, when we looked at this picture earlier, we were able to come up with the reason that this one didn't belong, didn't we? This one has an empty inside, and these are filled in. So therefore, we said this one didn't belong. When you were looking at the picture, what about this one? Why doesn't this one belong? Is that because it has three sides and the others have four sides? Now, when we look at these two, it's a little tricky, isn't it? When we look at this one, I think I would go with the fact that this one is a square. And what do we know about the angles of the square? The angles of the square are square, and they are right angles. What about these angles? These are more obtuse or acute, so they don't have the same angles as this one. That might be the reason they don't belong. All right, here's one more. Andrew Gale built this one on this website, whichonedoesntbelong.ca. Take a look at the money here and see if you can figure out a reason why each one of these don't belong. All right, third graders, did you look at this? I'm betting you came up with some reasons that these don't belong. Let's start with the pennies. Why do you think the pennies might not belong with the other four? Well, I could say that there is one, two, how many pennies are there? Three, four, five, and then there's also five up this way, so there's 25 pennies. Are there 25 items in the other two or three? Nope. Okay. So that might be why that one doesn't belong, because there's 25 individual pieces of money. Could that also be true for the opposite, kind of the opposite idea with the quarter? There's only one piece of money. So this one doesn't belong, the quarter doesn't belong, because there is only one piece of money. Huh. Well, then this one, there's five pieces because these are nickels. And how much money does that equal? Five nickels equals 25 cents. So all three of these, this one, the pennies, oh, my five is kind of wonky there, and this one are all worth 25 cents. What kind of nickel or what kind of money piece is this? These are dimes. So although it's like this one in the fact that it has five, how much money is five dimes worth? If you said five dimes is worth 50 cents, you are correct. And that would be why this one doesn't belong with the others. Your turn. You can make one of these at home for your learning partner or even a stuffed animal and quiz them. The rules are there are four different things and they each have at least one thing in common with the other three, but they also are individual. You could take a picture of your which one doesn't belong and send it to your teacher. We hope you have enjoyed this brief lesson on which one doesn't belong. Keep coming back. We will have these every once in a while. If you would like to try out some of your own, here's the website you can go to try out some that other people have already made. Enjoy your learning!